Hi everyone, today I'm gonna share with you this vlog which was taken like a week before, so week back, and this is like a beach vlog. So here we are all dressed up on a Sunday morning to go to Reliance Mall, and few of you asked for to show our car. So this is our car, it is a Swift car, and so we are ready to go to Reliance Mall. So both the kids are very excited, and now it's in the evening and we are all ready to go to a beach which is nearby, like 30 minutes travel from our house. So there Mahi is saying hi, and Maha is all excited and dressed up to go to the beach. So she's very excited, and I'm just rushing everyone because it's already late in the evening. So Mahi is waiting for her grandma. So that is my mother-in-law. So now we are going to the beach, and you can see that Mahi is having a great time putting her leg up and enjoying on my lap. So there's Maha, and we all are pretty excited. So that is the beach, and we are slowly nearing it. So I thought of showing you, if we go to the go in the straight road, there comes the beach. So this is a beach, and if we travel like 5 minutes on this road, there comes Chottavalai beach which we are going to visit. So if you go like this, there is Chottavalai beach, and many of you asked to show like tourist places in my Kanyakumari district and Nagarkoil. Actually this is one of the best beach because we visit it often, and it's quite it's not too much rush like Kanyakumari, and it is a little bit peaceful on this beach. The beach name is Chottavalai, and I will soon share other places when we visit there. So that is the view of the beach. So my Sunday, I like to go to few places and stay away from cooking and blogging because I just want to freshen up my mind and get ready for the coming week. So this is the view of the beach. This is one of my favorite place. We used to visit it at least once in a month. So Mahi and Maha is pretty excited to get into the water. So Maha is going with her father. So that's my sister. So she's going to take some pictures of Mahi and Maha. I like to just relax on the sand and watch the kids playing, because if I get all wet, and it is not too much fun for me because I don't like getting my dresses wet and things. So there Mahi and Maha is playing with the sand, and that's my sister. She doesn't want to show her face. Her YouTube channel is Miss Shah Heart. So she is quite little bit shy. So that is the view of the beach, and we came a little bit late. So the sun has already set, and that is Bajji, and Maha is asking me to put it in her mouth. And I'm going to show you quickly because Mahi is ready to throw sand at it. So that is chili bajji and raw banana bajji, and there she puts sand. So now we are back home, and I have already soaked rice for making appam batter, and that is raw rice which I have soaked overnight, and this is my mom's recipe. So it has raw rice, tender coconut flesh and some cooked rice. These three ingredients are ground together to make a smooth batter. So my mom taught me this recipe, and it has just three ingredients and it is pretty easy to make. So the measurement is, if you take 1 cup of raw rice, you have to soak it for like overnight. And you need quarter cup of tender coconut flesh and 3 to 4 tablespoon of cooked rice. So I'm taking the rice, soaked rice, cooked rice and tender coconut flesh in a blender and add in some water and make it into a fine paste. So you don't need wet grinder to make this batter, just use a blender. I'm using my Preeti Zodiac blender and it grinds pretty much anything into a smooth paste. So I'm transferring that into a container and I'm going to grind the other soaked rice, the leftover rice. And many of you asked about this container. This is JVL brand. It is available in Pothys. So you can find it online as well. So I have the link for this product in my description box. You can find it in Amazon. So you can check my description box for the link of this product. So now I'm going to grind the remaining rice. This appam batter is it's my go-to recipe nowadays because it is very easy to make and you don't have to like add yeast and other things. So what I do is once the batter is done, I transfer it to the container and let it ferment overnight. So if you grind it today night, you can make appam the next day for dinner. So there Mahi is asking for a snack. If she wants any snack, she opens the cabinet and take a plate and ask me. So she is quite sleepy as well. So because she's so tired and I have to give her a bath now. So now the batter is done. So you put the lid and let it ferment for like 24 hours. That is the thing. So you have to let it ferment for 24 hours. So add in some salt. I'm using this pink Himalayan pink salt and mix it well and leave it to ferment. So when you when you want to make appam, you add in some sugar and some baking soda, cooking soda, and mix it right before you make appam. And you can just make appam in the appam pan. So now I'm going to cover it and leave it to ferment. So now the batter is done for the next day. So what is this? It is a potato mixture which I made the previous day for like as a sandwich filling. So I'm just going to fry it, pan fry it, and give it to the kids because they are a little bit hungry. And today I'm not going to cook anything because I'm a little tired. So we ordered food from outside. So I have flattened the mixture. So I divided it. I just have only two portions. So I divided into two, and I have flattened it into a patties. And I'm going to coat it in breadcrumbs. So here I'm turning off the stove because the oil is pretty hot. So now this is a breadcrumbs which I want, which I am currently loving, and it is called as panko breadcrumbs. You can easily find it in Amazon. So this breadcrumbs is very nice because it is a little bit coarse, and so that is the packet, and I got it from Amazon. It is pretty cheap because this is a 1 kg packet, and it will last for you for so many months. So I took half of it in a container and the remaining half I put it in the freezer. So when you coat it, coat chicken or vegetable in this, and when you fry it, the food tastes very crispy and crunchy. So I have taken few spoons of the panko breadcrumbs and I coated the potato patties with the breadcrumbs, and I'm going to pan fry it in little oil. So that is going to be the kids like a little before dinner snack. So cook it in a pan with little bit of oil till the breadcrumbs, the outer crust is very crunchy. So I'm going to flip it, and this tastes amazing with some ketchup. So it is like a quick cutlet. So I'm going to give it to the kids, and I'm going to quickly show you, quickly tell you what is inside the filling. The filling has heat little bit oil, saute some garlic and onion and some capsicum, and then add in some oregano, some red chili flakes, mashed potatoes, cooked potatoes, salt, pepper and some mayonnaise, and mix it really well. This is the filling. I used that filling for sandwich the previous night, and you can make it like this too, like a patties or cutlet as well. So I hope you enjoyed this vlog. I will see you soon in another vlog. Thank you.